A Peter Rabbit Tale, A Spring Surprise. Written by Fiona Monroe. Illustrated by Eleanor Taylor. Inspired by Beatrix Potter. As Peter Rabbit was wandering through the wood, he saw something unusual. A sign was nailed to the old oak tree. It invited everyone to an Easter picnic that afternoon, and everyone had to bring something to share. Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail were preparing for the picnic. Flopsy was busy in the kitchen. Everybody loves blackberry juice. Mopsy was sorting through piles of wildflowers. I'm making garlands. I've got two jump ropes, said Cottontail, rooting through her toy box. What will you take, Peter? Peter felt a bit sad. He couldn't think of anything to take to the picnic. Mrs. Rabbit was making sandwiches. Everyone has something perfect to take to the picnic, he told her. What do you think I should take? Oh, I don't know, Peter, said his mother, hustling and bustling about. Take something sweet. Peter hopped off to see Benjamin Bunny. He found him tying brightly colored ribbons onto a kite to take to the picnic. My dad helped me make it, said Benjamin, and he flung the kite up into the sky. That's an amazing kite, said Peter quietly, but what should I take? Oh, I don't know, Peter, said Benjamin, a little distracted. Take something fun. Peter was still trying to think of something on his way to the picnic when Squirrel Nutkin scampered out through the trees and crashed right into him. What are you doing? Asked Nutkin. I need something for the picnic, said Peter. Do you have any ideas? Oh, I don't know, Peter, began Nutkin. Take something that's a bit different. Peter could not think of anything sweet or fun or different to share at the picnic. He was feeling very sorry for himself indeed when suddenly something small and yellow caught his eye. Maybe a flower, thought Peter, until it moved. Maybe a butterfly, thought Peter, until it said, quack. Peter scooped up the tiny yellow duckling. He scampered along the path as quickly as he could and saw another duckling and another. They belonged to Jemima Puddle Duck, and Peter knew she must be worried sick. At the picnic, Jemima Puddle Duck squawked and flapped and waddled and quacked when she saw her missing ducklings. Everybody clapped and cheered. You definitely brought something a bit different to the picnic, sang Nutkin. And something fun, laughed Benjamin. And something sweet, smiled Mrs. Rabbit.